Hello, everyone. I'm Pastor Tim.
And I'm Patty.
Welcome back to Couples in Christ. We're on Love Dare Day Number 9. I almost said, I don't even know what I was going to say. I was going to mix that all up. Love Dare Day 9.
Day 9.
Yes. Our theme today is Love Makes Good Impressions. And our verse is from 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 14.
This is what it says. Greet each other with a kiss of love. Peace be with all of you who are in Christ.
So, we've all covered some serious ground so far in our journey, learning to demonstrate aspects of love, patience, kindness, and encouragement are not always easy, but are certainly crucial to any healthy relationship, especially with your spouse.
Right. And so dealing with the way we greet your spouse each day may seem inconsequential, but this small issue carries great significance. Mm-hmm.
Right. You can tell a lot about the state of a couple's relationship just from the way they greet one another. You can see it in their expression, their way they carry themselves, as well as how they speak to each other.
Yes. And sometimes it's even more obvious by their physical contact. Contact. We're both tongue-tied, I guess, for this one. But how much importance should you give a greeting?
Well, the Bible has more to say about greetings than you might expect. The Apostle Paul took time to encourage his readers to greet one another warmly when they met. In fact, near the end of his letter to the Romans, he asked fellow believers to greet 27 of his friends and loved ones for him as he was in prison. He even took the time to list each and every one of them by name. And if you go to the end of Romans, I think 15 or 16, you can read all the names.
Wow, very cool. But it's not just your friends. Jesus noted in his Sermon on the Mount that even pagans speak kindly to people they like. That's easy for anyone to do. But he took a step further and said that being godly included being humble and gracious enough to address even your enemies with kindness.
Oh. Now, this does raise an interesting question. How do you greet your friends and coworkers and neighbors? How about acquaintances and those that you meet in a public square?
You may even encounter someone you don't necessarily like. Yet, you still acknowledge them out of courtesy. So if you're nice and polite to the other people, doesn't your spouse deserve the same? And like, times 10 of that?
Now, it's probably something you don't think about very often. In fact, I don't think about it very often. That those first words that you say to your spouse when you wake up in the morning, the look on your face when you both get in the car, the energy in your voice when you speak on the phone.
Your tone through text.
That's a
which
really,
is hard.
That's a hard one to
interrupt. But, you know, when you use all capitals and exclamation marks.
All the time.
You know what your tone is, right?
Yeah.
But here's something else you probably don't stop to consider. The difference it would make in your spouse's day if everything about you expressed the fact that you're really, really glad to see them.
When someone communicates that they are glad to see you, your personal sense of self-worth actually increases. You feel more important and valued. I mean, when you walk into a room and someone greets you, you just instantly feel better.
When somebody tells you, I'm so glad you're here today, it makes you feel better, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's because a good greeting sets the stage for positive and healthy interaction. Like love, it puts wind in your sails.
Aw. Now, I want you to think back to a story that Jesus told, a parable about the prodigal son. Now, this young, rebellious man demanded his inheritance money up front, essentially wishing his father to be dead, and then he went and wasted all that money on a foolish lifestyle. Soon, his bad choices caught up with him, and he found himself eating scraps in a pig pen. Well, humbled and ashamed, he practiced all of his apologies and tried to think of the best way to go home and face his father. But the greeting he was expecting was not the one that he received. Luke chapter 15:20 says this, "While the young man was still a long way off, his father saw him and felt compassion for him, and ran and embraced him and kissed him." Of all the scenarios this young man had played out in his mind, this was probably the least likely one he expected. But how do you think it made him feel to receive his father's embrace and hear his thankful tone? No doubt he felt loved and treasured once again. So, what do you think it did to their relationship? take a moment to think about
right.
that.
Right, well, it probably made it a lot stronger, right?
Yeah. Definitely changed. He thought it was going to be like a servant,
yeah,
the master relationship, and it was still a father-son relationship. Yes. Yeah.
So what kind of greetings would make you feel like that? Feel welcomed and loved? How could you excite his or your spouse's... How could you excite your spouse's various senses with a simple word, a touch, a tone of voice? A loving greeting can bless your spouse through what they see, hear, and feel.
Think of all the opportunities that you have to greet one another every single day, just on a regular basis. Like when they come through a door, or when you meet for lunch, or when saying goodnight, when talking on the phone. I mean, you can come up with probably 24 more ways.
It doesn't have to be bold and dramatic every time, like he was playing around with. It doesn't have to be a Nicholas Sparks movie every time you greet each other, right? You don't have to do the slow motion run down the beach to embrace each other every time you meet. But abiding warmth and enthusiasm gives you the chance to touch your mate's heart in subtle, unspoken ways.
Think about how you greet your spouse. Do you use that time well? Does your spouse feel valued and appreciated? Do they feel loved? Now, and even when you're not getting along too well at that moment, you can lessen the tension and give them value by the way you greet them.
Remember, love is a choice. It's a verb, right? Love isn't a noun. So choose to change your greeting. Choose love.
All right, today's dare is to think of a specific way you'd like to greet your spouse today. Do it with a smile and with enthusiasm. Then determine to change your greeting to reflect your love for them.
So let's pray together. Dear Lord, greeting each other with love and respect seems like such a small task.
Help us to take a good look at how we greet and talk to each other as we go through our day.
Help us always to keep in sight how to make our partners feel better by the way we greet them.
Show us how we can improve in this area and give us the wisdom to make these changes.
Amen.
Amen. Well, that's it for today. I guess that's, we'll see you tomorrow for Love Dare Day number 10.
Yes.
So have a blessed day in Christ.
We'll see you later. And remember, greet each other and love each other.
Bye.
Bye.